Hello friends, in the continuation of Moho animation training, in this video, I will teach the style section. If you are interested in these tutorials, be sure to click the subscribe button and the bell below the video. The style section includes color and stroke changes as well as color effects. We use fill and stroke to change the inner color and edges of the shape. And also we can activate and deactivate each of them. For this, we first select the shape with the select shape tool and then apply the changes. By selecting the dropper and dragging, we can choose the desired color from within the workspace. And with the width option, we change the stroke diameter. Using this tool, we change the stroke mode with the available options. We use effect tools to create different effects. We use shaded to create an inner shadow. We also have access to the settings of this tool, which include blur, offset, light angle, and shadow color. The soft edge effect is used to blur the edges of the shape. In the settings section of this tool, the blur radius can be changed. Press Ctrl+R to see the final result and preview. The halo effect is used to create a luminous ring. In the settings of this tool, we can change the color of the luminous ring and its radius. We use the gradient effect to create several colors. Also, in the settings of this tool, the type of gradient and colors can be changed. We use select texture to apply the photo on the shape. Activate the Don't Repeat option to not repeat the texture. To create an outer shadow, we use the Drop Shadow effect. Also, in these settings, shadow color, shadow direction, offset and blur can be changed. We use the crayon effect to create a color pencil looks and mess up the edges. To create spots on the shape, we use the splotchy effect. The spots effect is used to create colored spots. In the settings section of this effect, the size of the spots, the distance between the spots, the angle of the spots, and their color can be changed and adjusted. We use the three-dot button to see and adjust the applied effect. To remove the effect, we use the plane option. The swatches tool is used to select different color samples. For example, we use face for human face colors. We will use these colors in future lessons and character creation. To copy the color, we use the paste and copy buttons. The reset button returns the settings to the initial state. Checker selection is used to change the shape color selection mode. In advanced mode, we can create different color styles, which we will discuss in advanced training. Thank you very much for staying with me until the end of this video. If you are interested in these tutorials, be sure to click the subscribe button and the bell below the video.